Walking towards бабушка bringing ingredients.
I need to put on apron.
Yes.
It's a little bit tight.
Crazy Russian chef.
Do I have the younger boy? Yes.
Hello everybody, Crazy Russian dad and
Crazy Russian son.
And in the background, this is my mother. I guess you're a crazy Russian grandmother.
Hello everybody.
Today we're gonna be cooking
Babushka's recipe, the old style Russian recipe for solyanka.
Solyanka, which is like this awesome Russian soup, which I love very much. Very Russian, it's very iconic, it's very hearty. Solyanka is like, once done, you put the spoon and the spoon stands on its end, if it's done right. My mother will be the head chef, and I'll be the sous chef.
I'll be the co-sous chef.
You'll be the co-sous chef. But we need cooking names. I will be Jacques. You will be Charles. Jacques and Charles. My mama will be leading us. Are you ready? Are you ready?
I'm ready.
I ready? Am ready.
Let's do this, everybody.
Number one. We have to cut chicken.
I feel like a surgeon.
Thank God you're not.
I should have become a doctor.
No.
Mama, вы же хотели, чтобы я был доктор.
You faint at the sight of blood. Do you know why it's called солянка anyway?
Солянка from the word соль. Okay, scalpel. Can you see from there? You take chicken, not for vegetarian.
Only small pieces, please. Okay.
Is this good or do I need to cut more?
Yes, it will. Yeah,
okay.
Next one.
Can you see we're cutting chicken? That's our first step. Lao Tzu said a road of 1,000 miles starts with one step. And the solyanka starts with cutting
chicken.
Hold on. So chicken done. Next step, put chicken into the boiling water. I am like a real chef, everybody.
Be careful. Yes, very good. You have to clean the knife.
Mother always teaching me. I feel like I performed an operation. Maybe I can do somebody's appendectomy. Appendicitis. And next step, potatoes and carrots.
Just one potato and one carrot, which we add afterwards into the stew.
Potato and carrot. What do? Do I wash? Okay. And now, what do I do? Do I need to peel them? Okay, I think carrot ready, next potato. We peel potato, can you people see? Younger boy, how come you only filming? Okay, I'm still doing the potatoes, everybody. They tricked me, they said one potato, but it's two potatoes.
Dad, please don't sing.
На дальней станции сойду. We now have carrot and two potatoes. How come everything looks so bright?
Well, you're not in the shot. Lower yourself.
I will lower myself.
Okay, now I will actually cut something.
Can I take a small break?
From
no, not yet.
We haven't done much.
So how do I cut this? Small
cubes, please.
You heard the babushka?
I'm doing it correctly.
Yes.
Another time?
Yes.
Am I doing it right?
Not really. Yeah. It's gonna be too small. Yes, like this.
Amateur.
Very good.
Do I need some kind of
No.
Is this talking about it?
Yes.
You see how I like lowered my potato in the hole?
That's great. We're so proud of you, Dad.
Yes.
It's not a Russian dish if it doesn't have potatoes. And just because it has potatoes, it doesn't mean it's a Russian dish.
Wow.
It's a bit of a conundrum there, it's sort of the enigma of sorts.
That's not an enigma at all.
Mama, I finished first.
Oh,
I show.
Okay, why don't you show?
You like potatoes? You like my hat? My chef name is...
Jacques.
I am Jacques. They don't look as good as mine. No.
I think that's not true. I think we all know who cuts
okay.
Potatoes
in the soup we will see. When you see like crappy big cubes, the younger boys. But the nice, beautiful cubes.
The ones that are too big.
The ones that are beautiful are mine.
Okay. Absolutely perfect.
Dad, they're not the same size.
I think we need another carrot.
Like I said, they tell you it's one carrot, but in the end it's two carrots.
It's always two carrots. Knife
around. Oh, okay. This
so
is
pala to propala.
Okay.
Okay, very good, guys. Next one, a lot of sausages.
I went to a Russian store and bought... So these are known as охотничьи сосиски. Hunter's sausage. And,
that doesn't
and
sound
what
right.
That means is that it's not the sausage from the hunter, it's not the sausage of the hunter, it's the sausage for the hunter. Okay, that was funny, no? As you can see, I am much better with a knife and I'm much faster and more careful than younger boy. It's not a competition or anything,
it's
but you
not.
Know, hunter sausage, everybody. You can buy it maybe at like a Russian store, Polish store.
Guess who finished
other.
First?
You cheated.
Please.
Let me show fanatics. You see this? Now we put this.
Oh, that was close.
Yes,
wait, so
yes,
you're
yes,
telling
yes.
me that this dish has chicken and sausages?
Next, we have hot dogs. I've bought at Whole Foods. You can get any kind of hot dogs. I got once made of turkey.
So a Russian dish has hot dogs?
Yes.
Russian
that doesn't sound
dish
very Russian.
Mama, сколько их надо? How many?
Two for you, two for younger boy.
Sounds good. One step ahead.
In Russian, hot dogs are сосиски.
That's more
yes.
of a sausage.
This whole hot dog was very confusing when I first came to this country, because hot dog means dog that is of high temperature. Mama, I was done before younger boy.
Oops.
But I'm above such things as competition.
It's okay.
What about this?
Open the package.
It says Cabanos. But I also bought them at the Russian store. You see this? They're like tiny little hunter sausages.
You have to cut everything.
Okay.
Yeah, this recipe is very simple. Whatever sausages you've got, just cut them up real
yeah.
small and
small
nice.
Small pieces.
So, Dad, you ate this as a child?
Of course. La 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 la. Mama, I'm tired. Cooking is hard.
I know.
As usual, I am ahead of younger boy because you're too slow.
I was filming.
Shh, you're not filming. You're dilly-dallying while I was diligently cooking. So, people, you take this cabanas or whatever the hell it was.
Isn't caban like a bull?
Caban is like a male version of a pig that is vile.
Okay, a boar?
Yes. A boar.
Yes, very
oh, sorry.
Did I almost cut you?
Are there any more sausages to cut?
No.
I feel like I bought and cut all the sausages in the blessed state of Massachusetts.
Next.
My favorite.
I'll cut two. You take that small wimpy one.
Yeah, it's enough.
I think we're just eating all the supplies here.
Next step, as you may have guessed, is that we put,
pickles.
Sorry, next step is we put pickles.
You can't have a Russian dish yeah. without pickles.
Small, small pieces.
Yes.
Small pieces.
Small pieces. You are so slow, Crazy Russian Dad.
I know, even though you had two
so
pickles.
Okay, so what's the next step? Remember how, like, I don't know, it feels like 3 hours ago, we cut the potatoes and carrots, they now go into soup. We're putting them into soup.
Very yes, babe. Hey!
Not that rich, huh? Oh, cooking is not easy. You're still watching, right? Good. Mama, what's next?
Dill.
Dill. Yeah. Укроп. Okay, I need to show.
Pickles?
I need to show.
Smaller. Yes. Very good.
Since when do you know how to cook?
Yeah.
As I, Jacques Cousteau, always say, anyone can cook.
Okay, guys.
Deal
very
Russian,
very
just
good.
Like potatoes.
Укроп,
ladies and gentlemen. The next step apparently is what? We need to grill this 25 pounds of sausages we have cut. Join us at the stove. We start grilling. Let's go. We're pulling you with us. Okay, a little olive oil.
Just a little. That's it.
Okay, and so now the 20 pounds of sausages go into... Как сковородка?
Frying pan.
Very good. Cameraman, make sure you see the...
I can see.
Can you see sausages?
Don't hurt yourself, Dad.
As I always say, anyone can cook.
Yes, we heard.
And then you gently stir. Singing is optional. You fry for 5 to 7 minutes. We're cooking.
Okay.
My mother and I are cooking. Mama, is it counterclockwise or clockwise?
It doesn't make
Dad,
any difference.
Yes.
What's the next step?
All this sausages go inside.
Okay, this is an important moment, people. Anyone can cook, but not anyone can cook solyanka. For that, you need to go see my mother, your babushka. Will it all fit?
This serves two.
This makes enough for two people.
Two Russian people.
Just kidding.
Stir the pot. Once again, this is the pot with potatoes, carrots, and now all these sausages.
Okay, now we need to put salt.
Is this good?
Okay, no, absolutely. More.
It's called solyanka because you put a lot of salt.
It's seasoning.
Hold on. And now you stir.
Yes.
We're so proud of you guys.
Pickles into stew. Next, we put olives. These are manzanilla with the pimento, Italiano.
Va bene.
Ten olives.
10 olives.
6.
8, 9, 10.
Okay, but it's give or take. You go by intuition.
Next.
Apparently, we're putting tomato ketchup. How much?
Two big spoons.
Did we have ketchup in Russia?
Yes, we did.
Who knew that we had ketchup in some way?
Okay.
Next step, we need to bring it to a boiling point and we leave it boiling for how many minutes?
It's about 5-7.
5-7 minutes. Do I need to cover it?
No.
You don't cover it. So while the soup is boiling, we need to apparently cut some lemon. I'll be right back, but please take over.
Do I cut off the end?
Okay.
And then just like slice it?
Yes, just slice it.
I hear in France, chefs have a little bit of wine while cooking. Babushka helping grandson to cut lemon.
That's it.
So basically, next ingredient is lemon. I hope you do a better job than my son.
Can you see it's yellow?
They can see, it's lemon. What do we do with lemon?
Wait and see.
And we are now done. It's beautiful. Now we need to try. So we're gonna be putting it into bowls. Can you see?
Very good.
We are now ready to taste the solyanka. Mom, садись. The way you eat the soup, you need three more very special ingredients, very Russian. One is smetana, sour cream, bought at Russian store. Very good. The second is dill, the third is lemon. And fourth, of course, every Russian dish is eaten with black bread. Bread for you. Okay, so what do I do? I put a little bit of
That's
sour
not
cream.
Not a little bit. A little bit of dill.
Okay, and then what? Okay. The lemon. Once again, sour cream, dill, and a slice of lemon. Yes, a slice of bread. And now we try. I'm so hungry. Are you hungry? Ladies and gentlemen, solyanka.
Actually, wow.
A plus. A plus.
There's so many tastes in here. It's really good. I like it. I've never actually heard of it before.
Dad, you are so loud.
The hero of today's operation is my mother, who is, I guess, your crazy Russian grandmother. Thank you so much for teaching me, a younger boy, and my closest 100,000 friends. Do not forget to subscribe to more awesome recipes from my mother. And go make a solyanka, approved by an American teenager.
Good night.
Thank you for watching.
Yes, good night, everybody.
Good night, your babushka.
Okay, I guess I'll have a bit more. It actually is really good. I really like it.
And if you're still watching, one of the tricks I have for you is to put some Russian gorchitsa, which is mustard, on the bread. Mother-in-law's mustard. It cleans up your sinuses. By the way, solyanka is excellent for curing jet lag. And by jet lag, I mean hangover. Okay, мне надо кушать. Good night. For real this time.